always complain about that chicken that they are going to, you know, Christmas is coming. That chicken is always making background noise and all. These are the challenges of being a Nigerian YouTuber. I didn't want to make this video long, but I hope you were able to like gain something. You see, I didn't make this video is like 7 minutes long, so you guys watch this video to the end, right? It's not 10 minutes, so calm down. Hi guys, it's your boy Awam Kenneth, and this is my random standing
hit
for
the
my
like button, video. Guys,
I just wanted to like see how it looks. It looks. I like the background here in this video. Anyway, so by the title of this video, you know that we're talking about challenges that YouTubers in Nigeria face. Nigerian YouTubers, where are you? Assemble. So I think the first thing first is electricity, so lights, right? Having good light, having good power supply is always critical for you as a YouTuber. For now, I live in an area where the light is quite stable, so that's going good for me. But before, like, it was chronic, right? It was not good at all. By the time you just take the light, you have lost all your mojo to just do YouTube content. Just create a video, like you've lost your vibe. Even if they bring back the light, let's say 10 minutes after, you're kind of like, ah, your energy is wicked. You don't want to do it anymore. Okay, and that's that about light. But if I were to move on to my second issue as being a YouTube creator in Nigeria, would be my dogs. So this issue is very particular to me. I don't know for any other person. I think I've watched videos on Dima Umar's channel where they always complain about that chicken that they are going to, you know, Christmas is coming. That chicken is always making background noise in all her videos. Mine is my dogs. We have quite a lot of dogs in this compound, and there are certain hours of the days where you can't just do a video. In the afternoon you're good, in the evening just say no to that because they're going to sing, they like singing in the evening, and that's just horrible. Like, just be hearing woo woo woo, it's so annoying. Then thirdly, another challenge that I think a lot of YouTubers will be faced or have to face would be data. Even if you live in Lagos or Abuja where you have all those internet service providers that give you an unlimited, in quotes, unlimited, but we know what they're doing. In Abuja and Lagos, right, you still have data issues because sometimes if rain falls, it goes off. On Mondays, Spectranet and all those things don't work. In Lagos, I don't know why. Sometimes you just go like 2 weeks, there's no network, like it's not working fast. Then again, if it comes to how expensive it is, and everybody has the privilege to buy data. And if you want to do a very high quality video, you're shooting in HD, you want a high definition, you want to last more than 10 minutes, you have to upload your video. At the end of the day, it'll be like 1 gig, 2 gig, right? And if you put in some other effect into it, so that you just one video alone you want to upload, it's costing 1 gig or 2 gig to upload it onto YouTube's database. Then think about the people watching it. You see a 10 minutes video, like, this person wants to kill me, right? It's not happening for me today. Like, I'm not watching. It's the expensive data for me, right? So I mean, I laugh about it now, but it's not funny at all. Especially it hinders your growth as a YouTuber, especially in Nigeria. And if your content is mostly watched by Nigerians, right? Like, when it comes to making money, that will also affect it, because the longer people watch your videos, the longer ads are shown and your higher chances of making more money. So look at the biggest channels in Nigeria, for instance. Most of them are not being watched by Nigerians, especially like the comedy section. So let's say the Mark Angel comedy, Emanuela and Co. It doesn't trend properly here in Nigeria, but you see a lot of families in India, countries outside of Nigeria, and I think it will help them in terms of like revenue, because people draw a lot more ads in India and all those countries. So in terms of like revenue for the channel, that would be good. But if most of the viewers were from Nigeria, I don't think that would be good for them. So let's talk about electricity, dogs, and data for me. One last thing would just be confidence and motivation, right? So inspiration to just keep on going. In Nigeria, it's quite hard because me personally, I don't feel comfortable taking my phone outside and just like, yeah, I'm a YouTuber, I'm doing like a review of here, like, oh no, not me, I'm sorry. So yeah, and when it comes to like support from like family and stuff, I think you have to be a lot self-aware, a lot, you know, out there, provocative. So if you're like a mellow, chill kind of person, introvert, it will be quite difficult for you to, because people will be asking a lot of questions, giving you weird remarks, and yeah, it might not really go down well for you. But if you have someone that is just like your accountability partner, just, you know, Keda, why have you not released a video today? What is up? What is up? Like, why are you posting? Why are you posting? Why are you posting? Nice one, good one. Let's keep on doing it. Why don't like this? Do this. You know, you have that kind of person pushing you every day. That'll be very good for you as a Nigerian YouTuber. And then again, one more thing again, as a Nigerian YouTuber, if you want to do, you know, how Americans or let's say foreign YouTubers are able to like do some kind of niches that will work well for them. So let's say book review, some other niches that are, let's say motivation, some other like slow flowing thing, like slow talking voice, you know, fast, you're not shouting. As you know, you're trying to do that would be very hard to pull off. Especially book reviews, like it's not very easy to pull off that. Not a lot of Nigerians go on YouTube looking for book reviews to watch, right? So this kind of niches I've just very had. Then even as a beauty creator, so getting brands to send you stuff, I remember I wanted desperately to be a tech YouTuber, but how will I get brands to send me stuff to review? Like setting up that whole negotiation can just be quite depressing if you don't have a lot of money, or you don't have any connections, or you don't live in Lagos. So there is, I think there should be a separate videos for YouTubers who are not based in Lagos and how they survive. Because if you're a YouTuber based in Lagos, you've got it quite easy for you. The brands are there, people are there, you have a lot more connects there. A lot of people are open to work with you as a YouTuber there than in other places apart from Lagos and probably apart from Abuja to an extent. So me, I am based in just for the most part. Getting YouTubers to collaborate with you is very difficult. Getting brands to even discuss, you know, just discuss, come to the table, let's meet, don't pay me yet, let's just discuss. It's quite impossible, but nonetheless, possible still, but it's just a lot difficult. So these are the challenges of being a Nigerian YouTuber. I didn't want to make this video long, but I hope you were able to like gain something. You see, I didn't make this video is like 7 minutes long, so you guys watch this video to the end, right? It's not 10 minutes, so calm down. Anyway, see you in my next one. Bye.